chairs now waiting. Episode number 483. When was the Battle of Château Thierry? Two Chairs Now Waiting is brought to you each week by the folks over at Weaver's Department Store. Drop by over at Weaver's and check it out. There'll be all kinds of cool things over there. You can get the 1967 Andy Griffith squad car, and that's a little Hot Wheels version of the car. If you don't want that, maybe you want to get a deputy badge you can wear around and act like you're the big cheese. Use sheriff badges too if you want that. Head over to Weaver's Department Store and check it out. Two Chairs No Waiting is also brought to you by donations from listeners like you. The executive producer of episode number 483 is Tim Gerbrick. So Tim, thank you guys for being here with me. It's always great to have you join me here in Mayberry. It's so fun to talk about. Now, this week is a little different than normal because we're going to be talking about when was the Battle of Château Thierry. Now, I mentioned last week that, Barney's sidecar. Remember us talking about that a little bit last week? It was, at the time, June the 12th, 1918, is what it says on the Andy Griffith Show. It actually says the first motorcycle to cross the river, the Marne River, Battle of Château Thierry, June 12th, 1918. Passenger was Black Jack Pershing, and the driver was Corporal Nate Jackson, A.E.F. That's American Expeditionary Force. That's what that stands for. That's what it said on the plaque. If you remember that on Barney's sidecar episode, you guys have all seen that. So I'm going to play a little clip of that so we're refreshing that, and then we're going to talk about it a little bit more, okay? So let's play this.
Thought we might just fix her up a little bit. This cushion's all torn, stained, and everything. And well, here. Why don't you cover it up and give me a clean place to sit?
So you'll remember Andy and Barney are looking at the sidecar.
I didn't know what you thought.
And Andy pulled the seat out.
Well,
so that Barney could upholster
around that
the seat.
All right. Do it right or don't.
So Barney grabs the seat and starts to head into the courthouse. And then Andy looks down in the sidecar.
Did you see this?
And pulls out a big
down here where the
piece of
was.
Plywood.
Kind of a plaque or
where the seat was.
Or something. Look there. First motorcycle to cross the Marne River, Battle of Château Thierry, June 12, 1918. Passenger, Black Jack Pershing. Driver, Corporal Nate Jackson, A.E.F.
General Pershing, that's really something.
They probably did this right in combat as soon as they got on the other side.
More than likely.
Yeah.
What they probably did was to heat a bayonet and burn it in here for posterity.
Yeah. You know, I knew there was something special about the sickle the first time I threw a leg over her saddle.
You don't have an ordinary sickle there, Barn.
Nope.
You got a monument on your hand.
A monument.
You know, it probably ought to be on display someplace.
Yes. Like, all right. So that's what we're going to talk about right there. That particular little segment is what we're talking about. So the motorcycle, and I have one here in my hand, a sidecar that I made. I found a thing at, I found a cast iron squad car, not squad car, a sidecar, motorcycle, a sidecar at Hobby Lobby. And I took it and painted it green. And then I put the Andy Griffith or the Mayberry Sheriff's logo on the thing. And then I made a little piece of wood that actually says on the little piece of wood that goes into the bottom of the seat. It actually does say, I don't know if we can, the camera here for the video version can focus on it, but it says first motorcycle to cross the river. It says all that same stuff that we just heard. Anyway, so I've got this in my hands. Now, last week was 100 years. 100 years. So June the 12th, 2018 was 100 years after the documented case there in Barney's sidecar. So what I started trying to find out was that true? Now here's, and it hurts me deep because while the Battle of Château Thierry did occur in 1918, it did not occur, the best I've been able to tell, until July 18th, 1918. Because Wikipedia, and I've looked in other places to confirm Wikipedia was correct, so because this has been killing me, The Battle of Château Thierry was fought on July the 18th, 1918. Well, we just heard this was supposed to be in the Battle of Château Thierry, and they rode across the motorcycle across the Marne River on June 12th. So this was not after that. Now, most of the other facts are correct. It was the American Expeditionary Forces, the A.E.F., under General John J. Pershing, Black Jack Pershing. It was a battle in World War I as part of the Second Battle of the Marne. Okay, so there's all kinds of information about that. On the morning of July the 18th, 1918, the French and some of the colonial and American forces launched a counterassault under the overall direction of the Allied Generalissimo, I can't say it, Fernand somebody, Foch, against the German positions. Basically, it goes on about this. Its assault was about 40 kilometers wide on the front. It goes into all these details, and I'm not going to try to go through them. The Wikipedia article will be linked in our show notes. The main thing is I wasn't able to determine that this battle actually occurred anywhere, or a battle occurred anywhere near June 12th, 1918. I was really surprised about that, because I would think the episode, which was episode number 112, was aired, you know, I mean, it wasn't that far distant from the actual event, right? So episode Barney Sidcar, which is the one we're talking about, was episode number 112 of The Andy Griffith Show. It aired on January the 27th, 1964. So it wasn't that far removed, 50 years, or from, not even 50, from the actual event of, in 1918. So there were probably people still alive and watched that episode that didn't notice or didn't raise any concern. I don't know. I'd never heard that. So I'm asking you. You, as a fellow fan of the Andy Griffith Show, have you ever heard anything about this, that the date was incorrect? Oh, my. Now, I realize the Andy Griffith Show is not a history show. It's not a history. But I was surprised that they would have gotten the dates that incorrect. So, when was the Battle of Château Thierry? It was actually July 18th, 1918. So, could the first motorcycle ridden across the Marne River in the Battle of Château Thierry have been a month earlier? Ouch. It hurts me. Because while, you know, I do use the information from the Andy Griffith Show, you know, as gospel. So. So I'd like to hear from you. If you know the answer, please let me know. Send me an email at floyd@imayberry.com. Call in and let us know. I would love to hear this information from someone who actually knows what they're talking about. I'm not a historian. But this brought to mind, since we're talking about Barney Sidcar, you guys may not have ever seen this episode, but back in September 2013, I did a podcast episode called The Mayberry Sidcar. It was from the e-bullet of September that same year. Okay, so what it's about is, Jim Clark had actually gone, he wrote a story in the Bullet, and it was called Barney Sidcar Express, excerpts from the Bullet. So the Mayberry Sidcar. He did a report about it, the actual Mayberry Sidcar. Now, if you don't know this, there's going to be links in our show notes for you to go and read this story. I'm not going to read the whole thing to you, but I can tell you the actual sidecar, the actual motorcycle and sidecar, or actually, get this. I'm just going to read the first sentence about this so you'll know where it is. Jim Clark said, I had lunch one Thursday back in August. Now, this is in 2013. At Buffalo Smokehouse Barbecue, a new restaurant not far from the Arkansas River on the southeast side of Salida, Colorado. It's possibly the best barbecue I've ever eaten. He said he had to admit that, even coming from North Carolina. So he said that, but somebody he'd grown up in North Carolina and Tennessee is where he's grown up. Okay. So any other time he might be talking about here, the great barbecue and all that kind of stuff. But here's the real secret. As they looked at this, the family-owned restaurant, Rusty's daughter, is the Rusty's the owner of the place. He actually owns it. So go and check this out in the website. But here's where the amazing thing comes for, because they have in the corner next to the kitchen of the Buffalo Steakhouse Barbecue in Salida, Colorado, is the actual 1927 Harley Davison, which there's another problem, Harley Davison JD motorcycle and sidecar from Barney Sidcar. Okay, so he listed at 111. So it's 111 filmed, 112 aired, one way or the other. I know what you're thinking. The president, the goober, presiding goober of the Andy Griffith Show Realtors Club, has gotten into Colonel Harvey's Indian elixir, but no, he's dead sober and he has proof. So when you go and look at this, the stuntman, they've got documentation about where the motorcycle has been, why it's there. And friends, it is still there, the motorcycle. So they are slight differences, but if you go there and check it out, you'll see the sidecar and everything that Barney actually used. Over the years, it's been painted, and the chain guard down the front is not black where it was black before, at least on the episode, but it is documented to be the exact same motorcycle. Now, of course, here's another problem, as I just mentioned. What year was it that he was supposed to have ridden across the Marne River in this motorcycle? 1918. This is a 1927 JD Harley Davidson. So I guess I don't have to be too upset that the Battle of Château Thierry may not have been in June of 1918, especially since Black Jack Pershing rode across the river in a 1927 Harley Davidson motorcycle. Oh man, my hopes are, I don't know about you, I'm just crushed. So many things here. Oh my goodness, we're just we're crushed that this is going on. But these are great. It's a great article. You have got to go and read it if you have not seen it before. It's tells all kinds of stuff about the motorcycle, the stuntman who drives the motorcycle in Barney's sidecar wasn't George Dockstader, but that was who actually had the motorcycle later on, which is where it came from. George owned the motorcycle until sometime in the 1970s, and he sold it to Robert Bobby Falk, a good friend and longtime mechanic at Paramount Studios. And Falk kept the cycle and sidecar in good condition after he received it, except for one thing. And that is he eventually repainted the body of both the cycle and the sidecar to as close as he could get them to the way that they had been when Barney's sidecar was filmed. So there's some slight differences, and you'll be able to see what they are. But Rusty Graves is the curator of Barney's motorcycle and sidecar. He's the one that actually has it. He's been restoring and repairing antique motorcycles for more than 40 years. So if you are in the Salida is the name of the town, Colorado area, then you need to drop by over at the Buffalo Smokehouse Barbecue in Salida. I definitely need to drop by over there and check it out. Again, the link's going to be in the show notes so that you'll be able to find it. There were other things in there. They've got other motorcycles in there as well that you can see. So, all right. So there's two things. So I've broken all your dreams and hopes because of course, Barney does have the History of the United States of America written by Bernard P. Fife. So he does have that of the United States by Bernard P. Fife. If lost or stolen, please return to Bernard P. Fife. So this is part of the history. I'd like to hear from you. So if you know when that could have been, the Battle of Château Thierry, if I'm wrong, if it wasn't in July, if it was in June, that would be great. And if you know how Barney could have ridden a 1927 Harley Davidson, or not Barney, but Black Jack Pershing, across the River Marne in 1918, I think we need to find out how he did it, because we could all go back and live in Mayberry. Boom! This is awesome. I didn't think of that. All right, folks, that's what I've got for you tonight as far as that goes. I've blown your mind. I want to hear from you. If you're a historian, let me know. I would love to hear this. Folks, to end on a good note, let's go and hear from Randy Turner with this week's Mayberry History Report, because I know I want to hear some good stuff.
Welcome to This Week in Mayberry History, a report by special correspondent Randy Turner of the Gomer and Cooper Pyle Comic Book Literary Guild of the Mayberry Historical Society.
Before he was Uncle Joe in Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory and the Man in Chico and the Man, Jack Albertson was Aunt Bee's cousin, Bradford J. Taylor. Jack was born on June the 16th, 1907, in Massachusetts to Russian-born Jewish immigrants. Jack's mother and older sister, Mabel, worked as actresses. It was his older sister who taught him his first tap dance steps, and he later picked up additional routines by watching vaudeville acts who came through the area. Jack only attended a year of high school before dropping out and joining a vaudeville road troupe. He later worked as a soft shoe dancer in burlesque houses and then played a straight man to comedian Phil Silvers on the famed Minsky's burlesque circuit. When he was 33, he was cast in his first Broadway play, a musical revue called Meet the People, which opened Christmas Day in 1940 and ran through the following May. He became a popular Broadway actor, appearing usually in musicals, though sometimes in straight comedies. He appeared in half a dozen Broadway productions in the 1940s. He also acted in a couple of films in uncredited roles, though one is remembered. He was a postal clerk in Miracle on 34th Street who redirected letters addressed to Santa Claus to Kris Kringle, who was the subject of a court hearing. Jack also stayed busy as a radio performer, appearing in nearly 40 programs between 1947 and 1949, frequently on the Milton Berle Show. After a couple of more radio appearances in February 1950, Jack concentrated on becoming a popular television and film character actor, as well as continuing to appear on Broadway during the first part of the decade. He appeared in Top Banana on Broadway, starring Phil Silvers in 1951, then later appeared in the 1954 film version. 2 years later, he made his first of four appearances on the Phil Silvers Show on television. He also appeared in series such as I Love Lucy, The Life of Riley, and appeared 6 times on the Jackie Gleason Show. He maintained the same busy pace throughout the 1960s. He returned to Broadway in 1964 in the dramatic play The Subject Was Roses, for which he won a Tony Award as Best Supporting Actor. In 1968, he appeared in the film adaptation of the play and won an Oscar in the same category. Jack played the recurring character Paul Fenton on Mr. Ed from 1961 through 1964. He co-starred in the 1962 TV series Ensign O'Toole. In a 1963 episode of The Twilight Zone, he played the genie in a magic lamp found by Howard Morris, Mayberry's own Ernest T. Bass. And in 1967, midway through the final season, he played Aunt Bee's cousin, Bradford J. Taylor, whom she believed was a successful world-traveling businessman. But Andy learned the truth about when he found Bradford arriving in Mayberry in a freight boxcar. It is interesting to note that the storyline is similar to a 1958 episode of The Real McCoys, written by frequent writers for The Andy Griffith Show, Jack Ellenson and Charles Stewart. After appearing in the Willy Wonka film, from 1971 to 1972, Jack was a regular in the series Police Surgeon. He left the show to return to Broadway a final time to star in Neil Simon's hit play, The Sunshine Boys. There was a successful film adaptation of the play, but Jack had to miss that one as he had signed to play Ed Brown, the cantankerous owner of a garage in East Los Angeles, opposite Freddie Prinze, a young man he hired, in the popular sitcom Chico and the Man. Jack earned an Emmy for that work. Jack later starred in the 1978 series Grandpa Goes to Washington and kept actively working up to his death from cancer in 1981. He truly had a wonderful career, which received that early support of his older sister Mabel, the actress who had taught him tap steps decades earlier. And true Mayberry fans actually already know Mabel, even if they are unaware of the additional connection to the Andy Griffith Show. Mabel Albertson played Howard Sprague's clingy mother from 1966 through 1968. That's it for this week. Thanks for listening. And remember to take Andy's advice and go out there and act like somebody.
Wow. Thank you, Randy. That is a great report. And folks, Randy posts things online all the time. So if you want to make sure you don't miss any, go to turnersgrade@gmail.com. Send an email to that and he'll make sure you don't miss anything. Plus, Randy's got a book coming out. If you want to make sure you don't miss about that, email turnersgrade@gmail.com. Randy, great job. Thank you. I can't wait to see this book. Great book, all about Andy Griffith Show, by the way, if you don't know. So, folks, last thing I want to leave you with is there is the Mayberry Meetup that's coming up, the 6th annual Mayberry Meetup. That's right, 6th annual. That's the July the 20th through the 22nd, which is really the 20th and 21st. That's a Sunday is the 22nd, so we'll be heading out that morning after the Bible study. That is coming up. I want to invite you to come with us. Right now, it looks, well, I don't know how many people are coming, but there are 230 people that have already said they're interested on Facebook. I don't expect there to be that many, but there should be 60 to 80 people there, I believe. If there's 230, wow. If you're coming, bring a lawn chair, bring something to sit in, because we sit around at the gazebo at the Mayberry Motor Inn and visit and have a great time over there. So definitely bring your something to sit on, because if you don't, if there's 230 people there, we're not gonna be able to sit. But if I don't think there'll be that many, but they should have a great time. We sit around and watch the Andy Griffith Show episodes out under the stars. Okay, so it's not a concert. And we've got some ideas. Indiana Steve from our chat room has got some ideas of some things we can do. So does Otis. Until it gets dark, and then we will watch Andy Griffith Show. If it rains, we just have to figure out something else, because it'll be wet. It's wet. If it rains, oh, it's wet. But hopefully it won't rain on us, and we'll have a great time. So it's coming up really soon. Hope to see you guys there if you can make it. And we will obviously do reports about that as we go. So, friends, I hope you've enjoyed this. I hope you weren't too upset about finding out the historical inaccuracies I think I may have found, which I'm extremely upset about General Pershing, there he is, at the Battle of Château Thierry. Now, it was the turning point of the World War, just so you know there. But Black Jack Pershing, he rode across it. In June 1918, in a battle that didn't occur until July 1918, but he was in a 1927 motorcycle. Awesome. I hope that doesn't take away any enjoyment from you. I thought it was interesting. I didn't know it, so I wanted to share it with you. If you enjoyed it, I hope you did. Let me know. I would love to hear from you. You can give me a call at 888-684-8415. Tell me your historical information. Maybe we got something wrong. Either way, I'd love to hear from you. You can head over to twochairsnowaiting.com and click the contact link. You'll have all kinds of ways to get in touch with me there. So, friends, thanks for being here with me. Head over to Weaver's Department Store and buy yourself something. Have some fun. There's all kinds of great T-shirts over there. You'll love it. And I guess until next time, have a great Mayberry week, and we'll see you right here on Two Chairs No Waiting.